Good day, dear students. We are glad to work with you in this academic year, and we wish you success in this academic year. And today we have first lecture. Topic of this lecture about caries of deciduous teeth and clinic, diagnostic, and principles of caries treatment. Let's start. Tooth decay or caries dentis. It is a pathological process that started after tooth eruption. It is characterized by demineralization and destruction of hard tissues of teeth and followed by formation of a defect, caries cavity. According to the World Health Organization recommendations, there are three basic indicators for assessment of the affection with dental caries. So, prevalence, intensity, and grounds of its intensity. Prevalence, it is the ratio of persons who have teeth affected by caries to the total number of those surveyed. For 12 years old, from 0 to 30%, it is low. From 31 to 80%, it is average. And 81, 100%, it is high level. Age of curve of caries, so it is caries and deciduous tooth, permanent tooth, and caries of the root of teeth. Intensity, it is number of caries filled and extracted teeth in one examined. And if you see in your tasks DF or DF plus DFE or DFE, it means that you should blast. For deciduous teeth, decay and fillings that patient have. So if patient have, for example, two decays and three fillings, you should plus two plus three, and you will have five. In your tasks, you should write correct answer. For mixed bite, you can see DF, it is for deciduous teeth, and the big letters DFE, here extracted teeth. We plus DFE big letters, it is for permanent teeth. So in mixed bite, you should plus DFE plus DFE big letters, yes. And for example, DF, you should plus five, for example, and we can see two decays in the first molars permanent, you should plus 5 plus 2 and will have 7. It will be intensity. And for only permanent bite, DFE, for example, two decays, three fillings, and one extracted tooth. You should plus 2 plus 3 plus 1 and you will have 6. It will be intensity. And levels for 12 years old, you can see points here and level. Very low, low, average, high, and very high, and points. Next one, intensity of caries on tooth surfaces. It is number of caries affected or sealed surfaces of teeth. Also, DFF, then DFF plus DFE and small f, and DFE small f. Here you should plus all caries to surfaces. So, if in tasks you see that, for example, first permanent molar, patient have two carriers to surfaces that you should write to. Not one tooth, yes, but two. Next one, increase in the intensity of carriers and indicators is one and the same individual after a certain period of time. I think you understand DFE plus DF. Yes, if you have some questions, you can write your questions in Google Class and then we will speak about your questions. So, a carriers reduction, it is reduction of the increase in the intensity of carriers after carrying out preventive measures in comparison with the control group. And here you should determine by the formula reduction, it is MC, an increase in carriers in the control group, and in which preventive was not carried out, and M, it is increase in carriers in the main group, and 100%. Sorry, here I have some mistakes. MC and M. Next one, the prevalence of temporities carriers. So in Ukraine, the prevalence is from 6% to 99%, very high level. And at the age of 1 year, it is 15%. By the age of 3, it is reaches 46, and by 6 years, 96%. And some clinical cases you can see. Next one, factors in the development of dental caries in children. You should know about three groups of factors. First group, it is general factors. It is malnutrition, low fluoride content in drinking water, extreme influence, somatic diseases. And second group, it is local. Here you should know about pathogenic microflora of dental plaque, then changes in the quantitative and qualitative composition of saliva, and eating foods with high content of refined carbohydrates. And the third group, it is violation of the resistance of high tooth tissues, so defective structure, deviation in chemical composition, and hereditary predisposition. So you should know that about etiology I want to speak with you. So we know more than 400 theories of caries origin have been suggested from the beginning of development of stomatology. And the most known of them are the following: Miller's chemical and parasitogenic theory, then Antin's physicochemical theory, Lukomsky, it is trophic theory, and Sharpinac's theory, you should know, then by present time, it has been proved that development of dental caries is associated with the oral microflora, with the leading role of Streptococcus mutans, and above all. Then, etiological role of microorganisms is the development of dental caries. He has been proved by the different experiments on gnatobiotics or sterile animals. And they were not affected with dental caries even after a long-term cariogenic diet. Of course, you should know about signs of caries risk. It is viscose properties of saliva, acid reaction of the oral environment, the tendency to form dental plaque under normal hygiene conditions. Of course, it is enamel hypoplasia and hereditary predisposition, and toxicosis during pregnancy. Then, amount Streptococcus mutans in saliva, the number of lactobacillus in saliva, saliva buffer capacity, then plaque formation rate. About plaque, there are three stages of formation of the dental plaque. So, first stage, it is an organic film or pellicles, appears on the enamel surface. And glycoproteins and other saliva proteins make the basis of building of pellicles. The process takes from several minutes to several hours. The second stage, microorganisms and epithelial cells absorb on the pellicular surface. They stick to the pellicular surface and gradually start the growth of the bacterial colony. The stage lasts for several days. And the third steps here, it is formation of the major dental plaque. It accumulates extracellular polysaccharides and produced by the plaque microorganisms and saliva glycoproteins. At this stage, dental plaque is the most dangerous for the enamel as it actively produced organic acids and hydrolytic enzymes. So, dental plaque consists of microorganisms up to 70% and intercellular matrix. It is complexes of glycans, aminoglycans, and proteins. So, according to modern concepts, the development of caries occurs as a result of a complex interaction of external and internal factors that are implemented in the microorganisms, saliva, and enamel structure. So, next one, influence of Streptococcus mutans on the development of caries is confirmed experimentally. Implementation of cariogenic influence occurs by colonization in the oral cavity and formation dental plaque. And tooth plaque, as I said you on previous slide, is a conglomerate based on microorganisms, so up to 70% on the volume and fixed on a polysaccharide basis. Okay, and microscopic pictures, not here, here. So, dental plaque and microflora. Here you can see in table type of microorganisms. And then quantities about and this ratio frequency. Look please on this table and write in your synopsis. Not very difficult table, but very information. So, next one. Effects of dental plaque on tooth enamel. First of all, it is demineralization of enamel under the influence of organic acids, plaques, and formed during the fermentation of carbohydrates by microorganisms. Next one, it is dissolution of the organic enamel matrix under the influence of proteolytic enzymes produced by plaque microorganisms. And the last one is isolation of the tooth surface from the effects of saliva. Classification of caries. On practical lessons and on exams, on test tasks, you will have different questions about classification. You should remember this classification. It's not so difficult, but it give you very big knowledge for clinical practice. For example, first it is by the depth of the lesion. It is clinical classification. So, initial or spot stage, surface, middle, and deep decay. Then by localization. Fissure caries, proximal, cervical, circular, and combined localization. By the nature of the clinical sores, can be acute, chronic, and sharpest or blooming. Then, according to the sequence of occurrence, it is primary and secondary caries. By the presence of complications, can be simple and complicated. Then, black classification, you should know it, this classification. Next one, it is anatomical. Animal caries, dentine caries, and caries of cement. And by the degree of activity, can be compensated, subcompensated, and decompensated. Clinical diagnostic of dental caries. You should know about basis examination methods. It is interview, inspection and sounding, temperature samples, and percussion. Then, additional examination method. It is a vital staining, ultraviolet dentoscopy, electrodontometry, and X-ray. So, caries progress in deciduous teeth of young children has some particular features, and method of child feeding is very important. Most bottle-fed children have caries-affected teeth earlier, and the caries process is more active than in breastfed children. Then, caries in deciduous teeth at the stage of root formation. So, development of caries in deciduous teeth is characterized by acute and subacute progress. Caries lesions are mainly localized in the cervical areas of upper incisors, as well as in fissures of the first and second deciduous molars. Caries progresses is fast, and it spreads through the dental surfaces and moves to caries resistance zones. Caries resistance zones, if you remember, it is vestibular surface of incisors and tubercles of molars. Then, caries in deciduous teeth at the stage of root formation is characterized by the fast transition from uncomplicated to complicated form. That is caused by anatomic features of dentine and pulp in deciduous teeth during this period. This period characterized by white dentine caduceus and a thin layer of low mineralized dentin over the pulp. Large size of pulp chamber, pulp horns are located close to enamel dentine junctions. And so, caries of deciduous tooth at the stage of formed root. So, acute initial caries. Yes, we will speak about complaints. This caries is a fast flowing stage of caries in deciduous teeth. Thus, it can be rarely clinically diagnosed. Caries spots are more often clinically defined on vestibular surfaces of the deciduous incisors, as these segments can be easily examined. And after the removal of dental deposits and drying of the surface, the doctor can see white enamel locus, which has lost its natural shine. Acute initial caries can transform into a chronic process of acute superficial caries. Then, superficial caries in deciduous tooth usually has an acute progress, and it is a result of acute initial caries. Localization of acute superficial caries corresponds to the localization of caries spot. Enamel defects are easily noticed as clinical examination. They look as shark-like changed enamel with visible destroyed structure. So, There are no complaints as a rule, and a chronic process of superficial caries in deciduous teeth at the stage of front roots is very rare. It is characterized by absence of subjective sensation. It is usually defined during child examination, and caries defect in the form of a dark brown spot is localized on vestibular surface of upper deciduous incisors or other teeth. And probing doesn't cause painful sensation in this way. Most general complaints, it is for the presence of the cavity in the tooth, of course, food retention between teeth, if it is proximal caries, then less often painful sensation arising under the influence of chemical temperature and mechanical stimuli. However, in most cases, caries of deciduous teeth in children is asymptomatic and is detected only during a dental examination. Next one, moderate caries. It is acute moderate caries in deciduous tooth is one of the most widespread clinical form of caries at the stage of a formed root. A child complain about food stuck between teeth, sensitivity to chemical and thermal irritants. Then absence of complaints is possible as well. During examination, the doctor reveals a carious cavity with a narrow extrans. Then enamel edges are colored matte white, and dentine of the carious cavity is light yellow or yellow. It is soft and it can be removed with an excavator. The carious cavity gets white in trans when these edges break off. Probing of the bottom and walls of the carous cavity is painless, but probing in is not always objective due to the child's psycho-emotional stage during treatment. And chronic moderate caries is mainly localized on proximal surfaces, rarely on occlusal and chemical surfaces. And of course, development of this form of caries in deciduous teeth is asymptomatic. Deep caries in deciduous teeth deep caries. So during examination, the doctor should carefully examine the caries tooth and pay attention to caries intensity in deciduous tooth, as well as determine the child's somatic health status from anamnesis. A carious cavity is localized within parapulpar dentine. Its depth in deciduous teeth cannot be defined as an absolute value. Its distance to the pulp can only be taken into account. A carious cavity more than 2 mm deep in deciduous molars of 3 years child should be estimated as deep caries. At the same time, a caries cavity of the same depth in 7 years old children should be estimated as moderate caries, as the pulp chamber by this time decreases. When caries cavity is located on the proximal surfaces of deciduous teeth, where the layer of hard tissues is seen, from 1 to 1.5 millimeters, and the distance to pulp is very, very small, complication of caries development develop faster. So this localization in most cases is the sign of complicated caries. Diagnosis of deep acute caries should be determined with special care after careful differential diagnosis with possible complication. Next one, inspection. I tell you about a Schalke made or less often a pigmented spot and painted this spot in yellow, brown or black can be determined. However, more often the presence of the carous cavity of one depth or another is revealed. Sensing. determine the depth of damage of enamel and dentin, the consistency of dentin of the walls and bottom of the carrier's cavity, sensitivity in the area of enamel dentin border, and junction and bottom. Temperature sense, it is a pain due to thermal stimuli with deep caries, and it occurs only at the moment of the action of the temperature irritant and quickly passed after its elimination. For palpitis, paroxysmal pain is more typical and lasts some time after the removal of the stimulus and disappears gradually. With periodontitis, the action of temperature stimuli does not cause a reaction. For caries, always characteristic, it is painless on percussion. Remember, please. Then, vital coloring. After throughout cleaning and drying on the enamel surface with cotton ball, with 2% methylene blue, after 2-3 minutes it is removed, the excess paint in it is washed off with water. Intact enamel not stained and now waves demineralization out of Mihat carrier's color independent of the degree hard tissue lesions. Stomatoscopy in ultraviolet lightning. The diagnostic principle is based on different nature of the glow of healthy and carious affected areas of enamel. And healthy teeth in ultraviolet rays give a bluish glow. And carious spots are characterized, as it were, by quenching of luminescence with a clearer manifestation of contours of the lesions. Electrodontometry, the method is based on the ability of carious tooth tissues to conduct electric current of various magnitudes depending on the degree of their damage. When establishing a reliable contact between the active electrode surface and the examined tooth surface using an electrolyte solution, the value of the current passing through the hard tissue of intact deciduous tooth is in the range of 0.99 to 2.11 milliamperes. X-ray. In most cases, a carrier's cavity is found during clinical examination, but sometimes it becomes necessary to use an X-ray method. You can see X-ray, and here we can see the first deciduous molar. Then we can see proximal surface. It is deep carrier's. And we can see the nerve in this case, and in such situation you should work in the root canals. So we should do an endodontic treatment and then restoration. Method can be applied from 4 to 5 years of age and to detect carious lesions which are localized on contact surfaces, under the gums or under fillings. Its use increases the detection rate of carious by more than 80%. Apply in the process of differential diagnosis of uncomplicated and complicated carious. The X-ray often shows a discrepancy between the size of the cavity in the enamel and the extent of the lesions in the dentin. So it is focuses of superficial caries on the proximal surfaces and temporary molars. And after 6 months, you can see such picture. So proximal carriers is very quickly process. Laser fluorometry, most perfect, and the device is easily to use. Such device, for example, Diagnodent, company Keva, and principles of operation. A laser diode creates pulsed light waves on the specific lens that strike the two surfaces and are reflected. This light reflection is received by special photocells. The carrier's process causes a change in the optical properties of hard tissues of enamel of tooth, and the reflected wavelength is analyzed by the instrument and converted into digital values and an e-casting signal. Next one. Work method. The surface of tooth is cleaned of soft plaque and dental deposits. The surface of the tooth is dried. With the help of sensor, the investigated area of tooth tissues is illuminated. And after a few seconds, the study data appears on the digital display in the form of digital indicators. And using the device, caries is detected in 90% of cases, and you can see from 0 to 14, from 15 to 25, from 21 to 90, and correspond intact enamel structure, then caries within the enamel and caries within the dentin. Then, peculiarities of the current of temporities, caries at the stage of root formation. Acute and acute course, multiply lesions and symmetrical arrangement of defects, then localization. The teeth of the upper jaw, mainly in the cervical region, and a rapid progression of the most process along the plane, a circle shaped with the involvement of immune zone, and without subjective sensation, and fast transition to complicated form. Some clinical cases, please look at this caries on cervical, it is cervical caries on vestibular surfaces of the incisors, and it is moderate caries, it is deep caries cavities. So here we have also deep caries cavity, and it is pulpitis or periodontitis. And please look the clinical cases if a patient don't go to treatment. Then acute medium caries is the most common clinical form. Localization, proximal surfaces of molars, less often the chewing surface and cervical area. Most cases are a complicated process and no subjective sensation or complaints about food retention. And clinical cases, please look, it is proximal caries, it is 54, 55, 64, and 65. Look, please. So, if we want to know about caries intensity of surfaces, we should blast all these surfaces. Here we will have result 4. And proximal caries 84 teeth. Specific features of the time caries, it is at the stage of root resorption by the depth of lesion, medium and deep caries prevail, often complicated forms, chronic pulpitis or chronic periodontitis. Then localization, proximal surfaces to 60%, and the acute course of the process very rare. The initial caries is spotty, spotted after the teeth, much of on the vestibular or, sorry, here it is cervical surfaces of the crown of the tooth, and acute and chronic. So acute, no complaints or cosmetic defect, spot of white mate color, most often on the vestibular surfaces in the cervical areas, an area of white enamel which has lost its luster. The enamel surface is smooth, sometimes rough. When probing, it is painless. After drying, it becomes matte. And a chronic course complaints of a yellow brown or black spot. And when probing, the enamel is smooth, painless, and quite hard. Types of caries treatment. You should know about non-operative method. It is remineralizing therapy or impregnation treatment. Treatment of caries in deciduous teeth can be performed without filling. The choice of the method of treatment, medication, and filling materials depend on the following factors. First of all, is the period of tooth development, a tooth group, then depth of hard tissue lesions and caries cavity localization, the character of pathological process, acute or chronic, and caries intensity. Defining the presence of contaminant diseases of intestinal organs and system, it is also important. So there are following non-operation methods of caries treatment in deciduous tooth. It is remineralization therapy and impregnation treatment method or silver impregnation. They are used for treatment of initial form of caries in deciduous teeth in children. For young children, in case of acute initial and superficial caries in deciduous teeth, in the stage of root formation or stabilization. Remineralization therapy is done with the use of medication contains ions of calcium, phosphates, and fluoride. And fluoride, yes. Next one, taking into account the age of children and their behaviors, peculiarities in the treatment process, it is advisable to perform short-time manipulation covering the affected enamel areas for fluoride varnishes, gels, deep fluoridation of enamel. The method of deep enamel fluoridation has been development of Knapfost. Deep fluoridation means chemical formation of highly dispersive calcium fluoride with an average particle diameter of 50, which deeply penetrates into the spots of demineralization enamel and causes its remineralization. The procedure of deep enamel fluoridation is highly effective, quick and painless, which is very important in working with young children. The method of deep enamel fluoridation implies covering of teeth with the enamel sealing liquid. For this purposes, a dentist removes dental plaque from teeth and dried it, then applies liquid number one on the prepared enamel. In 1 minute, applies liquid number two and leaves it for another minute. The treatment course presupposes 3 visits. Then, impregnation method of caries treatment in deciduous teeth is a non-operative method also. And indication, acute and chronic superficial caries in deciduous teeth at all development stage. Circular caries in deciduous teeth, caries of smooth surfaces in deciduous teeth, then proximal caries in the frontal group of deciduous teeth at the stages of root stabilization and resorption. And treatment method, a 4% solution of silver nitrate followed by 4% solution of hydroquinone for precipitation of unsolvable silver salts on the demineralization hard tissue surfaces are used. Silver nitrate and organic compounds form abdominates that produce a protective film on the surfaces of enamel and dentin. Then treatment by preparation and filling, you can see. Caries cavity preparation in deciduous tooth is done with first it is high speed and mechanic hand pieces and burrs of various sizes and configurations. Then chemical mechanical method and manual preparation with excavators of various size. It is ART method. So, for preparation of caries cavities for filling with materials that have low adhesive properties, for example, amalgam, phosphate, siliconic cement, and in this, here you can follow the preparation principles by Black. So the cavity formed by the way of preventive expansion of the caries zone to prevent secondary caries, then retention and resistance properties of the filling. The cavity should be made comfortable for filling, and all caries dentin is removed, especially for prophylactic expansion of the caries for achieving a box-like shape. Of course, for preparation for glass ionomers or composites, don't use these principles. So ART method. So it is a traumatic method of caries treatment in deciduous teeth. Supposes the manual preparation and necrectomy of a caries cavity by excavators of various sizes. So and then you should fill in with glass ionomer cements. ART assumes the following technique. A caries cavity is cleaned of softened dentin with the excavator, then dried and filled with glass ionomer cement, and then you should doing a preventive examination. And general and local treatment. General, it is regulation of calcium metabolism in body, impact of the root cause, elimination of common cariogenic situation in the body, raising the immune biological abilities of the body generally, and creation of high resistance of hard dental tissues to general and local cariogenic factors. Then, specialist consultation. Of course, it is pediatrician, it is gastroenterologist, it is endocrinologist, immunologist, and ENT. Deep fluoridation method of enamels, I tell you on the previous slide. So, composition of the preparation number one and composition number two, and chemical formation of highly dispersed calcium fluoride which penetrates deep into the areas of demineralized enamel and contributed to its remineralization, and its it is medications. Surface caries localization, typical significant surface defect, and defect detected after teething. So, acute course possible pain from chemical irritants, carious cavity within the enamel injection of white color with uneven edges when probing roundness and softening. And chronic coarse pigmented enamel area when probing probe delay and enamel defect, of course. Treatment: dissection of the carious cavity followed by filling glass ionomer, cement, or compomies. Remember, compomies, it is combined of two type of materials, glass ionomers and composites. Then impregnation method of treatment, the affected surface in the absence of the possibility of filling, and isolation from saliva. It is a clinical case after impregnation of silver. Impregnation method, indications, I tell you, acute, chronic or superficial caries, circular caries, and proximal, and clinical picture. We don't use this method now in clinic, but you should know about it. I don't know about your countries, maybe this method doctors use. So, medium caries, short-term pain from chemical temperature irritants and presence of cariosis, tooth color is not changed. Yes, so acute, coarse, small inlet, a chronic white inlet, light softened dentin and dentin dense pigmented. So acute, light softened dentin and dense pigmented for chronic process. Treatment, of course, it is restoration by cavity followed by filling of composites, compomeres, and glass ionomeres, and Twinkie Star. It is material group of this material, compomeres. Then you can use, of course, glass ionomers, cement, and you can use composites. It is composite. Also composite, sorry, it is silver amalgam, and it is special silver mix for amalgam, and such mix we use also for capsules if we use capsules of glass ionomer cement. Deep caries, acute sore small inlet, chronic white inlet, light softened dentin and dentin dense pigmented. Treatment, dissection of the caries cavity followed by filling, of course. Thanks for your attention. I wait for your synapses and have a nice day, guys.